Navy SEAL spotted at Boston Marathon wearing suspicious backpacks. So let's see. Let's take a look right there. That is Chris Kyle, the celebrated sniper who recently lost his life. And we'll scroll down and look at some of the other images of these other SEALs. Now, just for one second, we'll pause on that image of Chris, scroll up just a little bit to the hat. And you can see he has the Punisher logo, the skull logo, and we'll move down to these other guys photographed of the Boston race. And you can see that's not the best image right there, but let's take a look at their clothing first before we move on to the skull images. Matching black jackets, we see the matching pants, the matching boots. Now, they're not wearing fatigues, but I would still call that a uniform. Even have matching backpacks. We'll scroll down a little bit more to some more images, and you can see the Punisher logo right there on the gentleman's hat. So these guys are walking around together. They're dressed to get, you know, dressed similar or pretty much identical, in fact. And you can see the logo right there on his hat. So I would say it's safe to say that these guys were in cahoots with each other. Now, what exactly were they doing there? The jury's still out on that. There's been a lot of speculation that these guys may have been up to some dirty deeds, or the jury is still out on that. And we'll keep you up to date on that in the meantime. Next story. Let's hope the Boston Marathon bomber is a white American. And I'm pretty sure you can guess who put this one out. If you can't, it's Salon, and I'm pretty sure you would have got that in the first two or three guesses. We'll go down here. The dynamics of privilege will undoubtedly influence the nation's collective reaction to attacks. We'll move down to the next paragraph. A religious or ethnic minority group lacking such privilege would likely be collectively slandered and or targeted with surveillance or profiling or worse. Now, this is the quote that sticks out to me. White privilege is knowing that even if a bomber turns out to be white, no one will call for your group to be profiled. So that's your white privilege. You guys remember a few weeks ago, Alex Jones ran the story that if you are white, you have to have your white bracelet privilege to show that you are privileged. And let's take a look at that Salon article again. There's a, if you go to their website, we don't have it on our website, but on the Salon website, maybe we can get a doc cam. You can see a picture here of Timothy McVeigh and Osama bin Laden. And right there. Timothy McVeigh and Osama bin Laden. Now, since the Oklahoma City bombing, the image of Timothy McVeigh has been used to demonize groups. What groups, you say? Veterans, disgruntled veterans, right-wing extremists, people who like guns, people who like freedom. And don't get me wrong, I'm not saying Timothy McVeigh is a horribly heroic guy. He definitely is not that. But his image has become the poster child for that. So yes, I would say he has been used to demonize groups, and the groups that he was associated with have become demonized because of his actions. Once again, I'm not saying he's a guy to celebrate, but is that the guy who got a call at his house because he went out and bought some ammo? Yeah, okay, I remember that story. All right, we'll move on to our next one. Boston Marathon conspiracy theory website is not what you think. It's actually pretty awesome. Let's find out what pretty awesome means. Theorists attempting to use the domain BostonMarathonConspiracy.com will find themselves too late. The URL has already been secured by a person concerned it could be used to host conspiracy theories. Now, this is some text from the site. I bought this domain to keep some conspiracy theory kook from owning it. Please keep the victims of this event and their families in your thoughts. Thank you. Now, you scroll down, and they just could not resist putting Mr. Alex Jones in here, because anytime you talk about a conspiracy theory, you have to put the right-wing activist Alex Jones and his infamous conspiracy site, Infowars.com, have also suggested that the attack was orchestrated by the American government as a false flag to infringe on civil liberties. Now, I believe the jury is still out on Alex. I know myself, I'm still waiting for more information to come out. We think there are some smoking guns, which I'll talk about in 1 second. But let's continue on with the article, the paragraph just below that. But as with Sandy Hook, most of these theories can probably be chalked up to coincidences. Let's just stop right there. Coincidences. There are just so many coincidences in the world. Like Dan Bondi had a chance to point out, the smoking guns. Let's say they're not running a bomb drill, which they claim. They say, we're not running a bomb drill. We just had dogs standing over here, bomb-sniffing dogs, right next to the bombs who didn't sniff out the bombs. So, I mean, did you train the dogs to sniff for bombs? Because there's a bomb, like, right over there, which they didn't find. Also, the loudspeakers were telling people, hey, stay calm, there's nothing to worry about, right before the bombs went off. And there's other things. I mean, we're not going to go into it all right now tonight, but there's plenty of stuff. And that guy as well, who had some damning things to say, and we'll get to that a little bit later on in this edition.